Hey there, friends. We'll begin this weather segment talking about the drought monitor, which has improved quite a bit. The drought has backed off quite a bit after the rain that we had a couple days back, and you can see the areas in yellow under the abnormally dry section of the drought or category of the drought. No more of the moderate drought for the southeastern Texas Panhandle. It is still in effect for our friends in western Union County, and we continue on with the heaviest drought in far northern portions of New Mexico. But this afternoon's rain, tonight's rain, will help to completely get that drought out of here, or at least get us fairly close to it. We're only about a half an inch down from our average for 2019 as far as rainfall totals are concerned, and we'll see quite a bit of rain moving to the area later on tonight. The upper level system, upper level low, of course, the winds around it in a counterclockwise orientation centered right over northern portions of Arizona. We're getting a lift in the atmosphere as the system progresses west to east. This morning time, a few rain showers stretching from, say, Clayton text line all the way down into southern portions of Roosevelt County. Nothing severe this morning, and we're just getting the cloud cover here in town. Let's take a look at that day planner forecast. Right at 46 degrees at the moment. The clouds helping us to only slowly cool down to, say, 45 by 7 o'clock. Rain showers and storms spread across the area, kind of hit or miss for the rest of the day, but we'll continue on with the better chance for storms later on tonight. So make sure to have that umbrella for your evening activities. And keep, if you don't already have the KAMR weather app, download that to your phone or tablet and make sure the alert settings are on so you can get alerts in the middle of the night. If we have storms, they get even stronger. Lake levels, Lake Meredith at 74.42 feet deep as of this morning, holding steady. Greenbelt also holding about the same, and we'll see those levels on the way up as the rain continues on into the area. Ute Lake coming down just a hair right now at 84 feet even. Now look at our travel forecast. Of course, we have this cold front coming in from the west. It'll help to increase the chance for some stronger storms later on tonight. Thunderstorms for the afternoon stretching all the way down towards the Big Bend area. Highs ahead of that system in the 70s and even the 80s down around towards Brownsville, 73 for the high today in Houston. Now let's take a closer look at the future sky forecast. The morning storms pushing up into northwestern parts of the Texas Panhandle and a few straggling down towards, say, the southern plains will continue on into the afternoon hours. Storms continuing to develop out to the west and move on in. And for the evening time, this will have the best chance for some strong straight line winds as this line really kind of forms up into a squall line moving west to east. By 10 o'clock tonight, most of the rain looks like it will be pushing past Amarillo and will be pretty much done with the rain to start out Saturday morning. As we get around to sunrise, well, we'll see clouds in the way, but the sky will be clearing out. Here's a look at our 7-day forecast. Tomorrow afternoon, highs topping out near 70, 73 on Sunday. A lovely weekend to be out and about. Absolutely beautiful and calm winds, fairly calm winds anyway. Monday topping out at 65. We'll get back to the 70s and 80s for the middle of this next week with rain again on Wednesday. You can take a look at that 7-day forecast at myhighplains.com. We're right now at 46 degrees, and we'll send it back to Angelina.